insecurities, and I finally have because I imagine me letting go of all of the ones who hurt me. Hello and welcome to the Lady T Show. And once again, I want to thank you for taking time out of your schedule on a Sunday evening to join me and allow me to come into your homes with another fantastic, fantastic show. Seated to my left, of course, is my co-host, my lovely co-host, Shantice.
Hello.
Say hello to the viewers.
Hello, everyone.
And you've seen her before. This is my blood sister.
Lord Jesus.
Yes.
We came. Not to tell too many people.
Oh, why you say that? Oh, my goodness. We came from the same womb. Right?
Not at the same time, but yeah, same place.
Yes. So this is my blood sister. She looks out for me. Those were some good old days, right? Back in the womb.
Yeah.
Sometimes I wish I could go back.
For me. I don't know what she felt.
Okay.
For me. Okay.
So we got to get into this because we have an exciting show planned tonight.
Yeah.
But before I do, I want to give you all an update. And I always like to update you on past guests that have been on the Lady T Show. Now, Kenny and Christian. Yes.
Yep.
Kenny and Christian. You remember Kenny and Christian?
I remember Kenny and Christian.
And you said it wasn't feasible for me to learn karate, remember?
I said it would never work it during this particular time.
Okay.
There
well,
something in the youth.
See, this is how you can't let people kill your dreams.
Right.
You know, if that's something that I want to do.
You never said it was a dream, but that, I understand that.
Okay. You would think your sister and family would support you, so.
Oh, wow.
Yes. And when I start doing karate, I don't want you to say anything. Cause
I used to teach kickboxing, so you forgot that, right?
I did.
Okay.
She did, in fact. So let me shut my mouth, because I remember how you used to beat me up when we were little. But anyway, Kitty and Christian, they are having their premiere of their movie in the summer.
That's going to be exciting.
It is. Now, last year when they were here, they did a little demonstration, and they had a lot of accolades and accomplishments then. But now they came back last month, and they were talking about the movie.
Mm-hmm.
So a German producer is going to produce a documentary on Kenny and Christian, and they're from right here in North Carolina. Warrenton, to be exact, I believe is where they live. But Kenny Facebooked me, and he said, the premiere will be in the summer, and we want to invite you to the premiere.
Oh, now, where's the premiere at?
I don't know.
You just agree to go.
Okay. I'm going to go, though. I'm going to go. I'm going to be there.
Just go.
That's how Lady T does. And I'm honored to get that, though, because it feels, you know, it makes me feel like I'm going to the red carpet, you know?
Oh, yes. Yes. I bet.
So I got to
find out where we're going. Could be in Tokyo. It might be in
Hey, I'm there. Kenny and Christian, I am there. So I got to find a new outfit now so I can go to the premiere of The Life of Kenny and Christian Buffalo. Oh, this is so exciting. I didn't invite you. I heard you say we just a minute ago.
Oh, wow. Oh,
so she said we need to find out where.
I just love how Lady T just reminds us of who show it is.
Yes, it's the Lady T Show.
Yes.
So all our theme tonight is Lady T Show in plus size. And we are going to talk about plus size fashion. Plus size fashion. It is. And I have to say, I am proud of the way society has kind of turned around the negative connotation of being plus size, you know, because coming up in school, if you were plus size, you were picked on. Nobody wanted to
you
be your friend.
You were the butt of everybody's jokes.
Exactly. Exactly. So they kind of turned that around now because we see plus size models. We see plus size actors.
Yeah.
So this is great. This is a great thing that society is doing. And, you know, I thought about when our grandmother was coming up, she was plus size. She was kind of hippie. So
she carried a lot of weight.
She
though.
Did.
Yeah.
She did. But I don't think the plus size was a big deal back then. I think that was kind of wanted. It was warranted back then. But then we kind of moved over into if you were.
The media kind of moved us.
Right.
Us over.
So they're kind of moving us back, which is a good thing. So we want to make sure that our young ladies and our guys and boys and young men, they are happy with themselves and the way they are. And that falls along with self-esteem a lot.
Mm-hmm.
So if you have a low self-esteem, that's going to reflect in the way you look, in the way you carry yourself. Also, you got to think about who's around you, family members, friends.
The inner circle.
Right, because they have a habit of making you feel like being plus size is.
Now, I know you were not getting ready to say that your family and friends made you feel what now?
No. Okay. I wasn't. But I was going to say I was engaged to somebody. You probably don't know this. I was engaged to somebody who did try to make me feel like, you know, I should lose weight. You see, the look on her face is like, I didn't know that.
Okay.
Yes.
The camera just brings out truth.
Yes, it does.
Yeah.
So I was engaged to this person, and he would hint every now and then that I needed to lose weight. But
and
you
nine
know,
times out of ten, the one that's hinting is the one that's overweight.
Well, in his case, let me tell you, I'm glad for family and friends that will, you know, mm-hmm. let you know you got to pick your self-esteem up, and they'll make sure that they're showing you as much
that's
love
right.
because I looked at him and I'm like, you know, with your little bird chest, you're going to tell me I need to lose weight. It, you know, it's things like that. I didn't.
Things that make you go,
You're kind of wondering who it is, right? You probably, when I said that.
Yeah.
When I said bird chest
gave
that,
it away.
That gave it away. So the nerve of him, right?
Exactly.
The nerve of him to tell me.
If I'm thinking of the right one, yeah.
A little bird chest. With little bird legs to go along with little chicken legs.
Wow, okay.
So, okay, let's get back on track here because I have a tendency to get tickled.
Flashback.
So I had a flashback. Yes, I did. But we have plus size supermodels, actors, fashion icons, and they're mm-hmm. showing you that you can be beautiful and be plus size. And again, it's how you carry yourself.
Exactly.
It's how you dress. It's how you see yourself. You know, nowadays,
the whole attitude.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. And we have so many things that can help us out because nowadays we have designed items we can wear to kind of pull us in and suck us in, like the Spanx.
Oh yes.
It just came out, which is an updated
woman's best friend.
That's right. It's mm-hmm. an updated form of a girdle.
Now, so, with that, though, I would like to make a point because a lot of women are not plus size, but they wear the Spanx.
They wear the Spanx.
Because it makes you look neater. It gives
right.
that neater appearance. So
even if you're not plus size.
Size 12 are wearing Spanx.
You should invest in a Spanx. Mm-hmm. Or as our mama says, mm-hmm. without a Spanx, you look stank. That's what she says. That's what she says. I love my mama. I love my mama.
She's going to love us, too.
Yes, she is. But, I wanted to show this picture.
Wow.
That's what I thought about when we were talking about Spanx, that she said that a lot. She does.
She has a lot of sayings.
She does.
Yes,
she does.
A lot of sayings.
I love you, Mama. We want to show this picture. This picture has received a lot of focus, a lot mm-hmm. of attention, a lot of focus has been on this picture of Erica Campbell. Now, this is Mary. She's of the group Mary Mary, the duo, dynamic
oh,
duo,
wow.
Mary Mary.
Okay.
This is the dress. Mm. That was on her album cover. Now, they talk about her a lot with this because being a gospel CD.
Yeah, I see now.
Okay, so you.
I see now.
Okay.
Yeah.
You know, when I looked at it, I've seen them wear revealing things before.
Not this. It kind of puts you in the mind of a hip hop.
Okay. I mean, it's a little snug.
Be it regular size or plus size, wouldn't you say that should still be a standard, even
right.
if you are a gospel artist?
Yes, it should.
Don't see standard
yeah.
here.
It's a little tight. So, you know, when we look at outfits like this, we have mm-hmm. to think about what kind of message we're conveying.
The image.
And she's
the
a
image.
Little on the plus size, you know?
Yeah. But it's still, you want people to be able to give you credit.
Right. Right.
For you being able to, you know, be stacked very well.
Exactly.
But this here doesn't say
it's
I'm stacked
much.
Very well. It's not as tasteful as
right.
I would have liked for it to be.
It's a little much.
Yeah.
It's a little much. And this picture that's coming up of Gabori Sidibe
mm-hmm.
at the Academy Awards?
I want to say Oscars.
Was it the Oscars?
It was the Oscars, yeah.
So we're going to take a look at her. She is plus size. And...
I think we as plus size, when I say we, because
yes.
I consider myself to be on a plus size
yeah.
Group as okay. well, we need to know our frame.
Right.
Learn your body type.
Okay. I think the feathers probably.
The feathers is a little bit too much for
right.
me.
Now take a look at this one of her. That's, again, it's the style is okay, but I think with the A-line, she probably should stick with the A-line. Now the first dress with the A-line style, that probably would have worked with
Yeah.
You know, it's if it didn't have the feathers on it,
right.
Yeah, so we've got to make sure that we're taking note of what we're wearing, and just look at yourself in the mirror and see how you look before you leave out of the house.
But I think that's the problem.
Yeah.
They're looking in the mirror, but they're seeing somebody else's body.
Right,
and it's, they're not taking it for what it is.
Right, and this also reminds me of one of my favorite movie clips from Fat Girls.
Oh, yeah.
Fat as P-H-A-T, fat, mm-hmm. which means good, good looking.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have the movie. I had it. Don't know what happened to it.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that must be, it's meant for me to look for it, right?
I mean, if you have it, that's a good time to admit that you have it. So I'm very,
bless your heart,
with
lady.
My things, I'm like that because I don't like for people to abuse
take
my things. Mm-hmm. I really don't. But in the movie, Monique, who is a well-known actress and comedian, she's a little plus size, but she's a very talented fashion designer in the movie, and she meets a Nigerian doctor who, ooh, that just kind of struck me right there. I don't know why, but it struck me.
Hit a nerve, didn't it? Yeah.
She meets a Nigerian doctor, and he tells her she's beautiful. And she tells him, well, I'm going to be even more beautiful when I'm a perfect size 6. And he says, you know, you will never be size 6 because your body frame is not meant to hold that. So, and she had to accept
that.
And we have to accept that. A lot of times, even when people go through drastic measures to lose weight, they don't look good. They end up looking emaciated, kind of. So, you know, this is about being happy with the way that that you look. So we're going to take a commercial break, and when we come back, we have some local plus-size models who's going to bring it right here to the set of the Lady T Show. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
Lucy Liu, with my girl Drew, Cameron D and Destiny, Charlie's Angels, come on. Question, tell me what you think about me. I buy my own diamonds and I buy my own rings. Only ring your celly when I'm feeling lonely. When it's all over, please get up and leave. Question, tell me how you feel about this. Try to control me, boy, you get dismissed. Pay my own funnel and I pay my own bills. Always 50-50 in relationships. The shoes on my feet, I buy. The clothes I'm wearing, I buy. The rock I'm rocking, I buy. Cause I depend on me. If I want it, the watch I'm wearing, I buy. The house I live in, I buy. The car I'm driving, I buy. I depend on me. Taught and sacrificed to get what I get. Ladies, it ain't easy being independent. Question, how'd you like this knowledge that I brought? Bragging on that cash that he gave you is a front. If you're gonna brag, make sure it's your money you front. Depend on no one else to give you what you want.
Shoes on my feet,
I'm
clothes I'm wearing,
I'm
the rocks I'm rocking,
cause
I depend on me. If I want it, the watch I'm wearing,
the house I live in,
some of the world's top fashion models, and we were just talking off camera about plus size designers. My co-host was saying that you don't hear of many plus size designers. You don't really see them, so maybe you should become one.
I can't sew. You have to sew. I would think you have to be some type of seamstress to do that. Now I could be a consultant, but not
expand
a
expand your mind.
That's true. Just like with the karate. Just like with your karate. Yeah.
Now you have this. So you can learn how to sew.
Mm-hmm.
You can learn. You could be a plus size fashion model or a fashion designer.
Mm-hmm.
So
That's a thought.
You can't. You can lead a horse to water, but you can't make him drink. Right?
Okay. So I'm a horse?
I knew she would take
it the
wrong way.
That's going to be another conversation off tape, okay?
Okay, yeah. Okay. We've got some local fashion models here, local plus-size fashion models, and they're going to come out at this time, and we're going to talk about the outfits that they have put together. They want to show you that you can be beautiful, you can be plus-size, and they are ready. I'm looking at them right now.
And all of them look lovely.
They look lovely. So we got to make sure that we take notes here, mm-hmm. and just look at them, you know, and they're wearing Spanx, like we talked about the Spanx, and sucking them in, pulling them in, especially if you can get a good Spanx, you know, you can also.
And they make different kinds. Yes. There's, if I believe, there's some that go underneath pants that goes down to the ankle.
Right.
They have the feet open. Then there's a half one, like the shorts, and then you have the body one now that comes all the way up to meet the bra, where the bra leaves off at.
But you got to make sure you're wearing it the right way.
The right way.
Mm-hmm. I've had them where they were too tight.
Oh, yeah.
So you don't want them to be too tight. Yeah. I don't want you to pass out wherever you are. So you got to wear them the right way. But we're going to get these local fashion models, plus-size fashion models out here. We want you to take a look. And also, we want you to email me at ladytshow@gmail.com. That's ladytshow@gmail.com. for your comments and your suggestions. Also, if you have a question about anything they're wearing and you want to know, oh, look at there, he's got the number, I tell you.
He's on point.
He's on point. So that's the number you can call, 252-567-8331 for your comments and your suggestions for tonight. Anything we've talked about thus far, if you have a comment, you can go ahead and call now, and we have someone on the phone line waiting to take your comments and your suggestions. But we're going to start that music track. We're going to get these local models out here.
Yay.
And they're going to model for you.
I love fashion shows.
You love fashion shows?
Okay. Yes.
So our first model that is going to come out, her name is Alicia. And Alicia is from, are you from Scotland, Alicia? From Scotland, the big city of Scotland, North Carolina. So come on out, Alicia. And she is wearing a black sweater.
That's nice.
That's beautiful. It's lovely. She's also wearing dark blue denim Levi's.
Okay.
And, you know, this color combination, I like this because.
And now with the Levi's as well, designers are now making them for curves.
Yes.
Like the curvy fit.
Yes, yes.
They look nice.
Because a lot of what you'll find is that a lot of pants made for African American women, they don't quite
not
fit
proportion
in the waist.
Well, yeah.
So we want something that actually fits. She's also wearing black heels, color coordinated with her sweater.
That's nice.
And she has classic pearl earrings.
That's nice.
And I don't own a pair of pearl earrings. You can buy me some for my birthday.
This is quite a far off, but it'll give me time to save up for it.
It's a possibility.
And
Alicia
my mind.
Is natural. And I like the way her outfit goes with her natural hair. Sometimes some outfits we wear, it doesn't quite go with her natural hair.
No, it doesn't.
But I like the way she has coordinated this to go with her her natural hair. So again, Alicia, if you would give us another spin, we're going to take a look at her outfit.
It's a nice sweater.
The sweater
I like
is
the way it zips on the side.
Thank you, Miss Alicia.
All right.
Our next model is Delmonica Vick.
Wow, looks good.
You know, there's a premonition that if you are plus size, you cannot wear print. But that's not true.
That's coming back. And the skin tone, the colors, goes very well. I'm noticing a lot of your tan and pewter, a lot of your good colors like that, is more blended with your print.
Yes.
If you notice that.
Like a
natural color. Yeah.
So she has a print top, and she's also wearing casual royal blue pants to go with this. Her shoes, her heels are matching the top.
Yeah.
I mean,
I like that. It sure is.
It's beautiful. It's beautiful.
Notice her accessories.
Yes, the accessories are lovely. Her earrings match the pattern in her shirt.
I just noticed that.
They match.
That's
very
nice.
Well. And I like the style. It goes along with her natural hair as well.
Mm-hmm.
Matching earrings to match the print of the shirt. She's also wearing the bracelets. Two of those, the wooden bracelets. Those are in.
I'm noticing a lot of that.
Right.
Stones and the wood.
Mm-hmm. Those are a hot commodity. So if you can get you a pair of wooden bracelets, wooden necklace, earrings, you are in there. So thank you, Delmonica, beautiful as beautiful.
And they are wearing these heels.
They are.
Jesus.
Our next model is Jasmine D.
Okay.
And we have another print here.
And every last one of them is very tasteful.
Yes.
Very tasteful. This is the look for either like work or just a casual look.
Right. And she's matched this up very nicely. She has
that is nice.
Rose colors. The roses in her
shirt.
They're kind of red and navy blue.
Yeah.
And she's got the matching coat to go with it. Mm-hmm. And the dark colored jeans go with this perfect. I like the fact she did not wear light colored jeans because the dark color is a great selection to go with this outfit.
Mm-hmm.
I think the lighter color jeans probably would have maybe would have thrown it off just a little bit. And again, she's wearing the beige shoes, which complements the outfit perfectly. The beige heels.
Yes, it does. And I like that the selection that everyone has chose for the jewelry. It's not over the top.
Exactly.
But even the accessories are tasteful with the outfit.
And these coats, this is perfect for this kind of weather.
Weather,
quarter length sleeves. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Elegant silk, gold bracelet. That goes
very
with
nice.
This nicely.
Mm-hmm.
And she's got her hair done. I like that all of the models have their hair done.
If you're going to rock it all the way.
That's right. That's
rock
right.
It all the way.
You got to rock it. Love and the coat is iron. You gotta at least iron your clothes.
But now wait a minute. Now the wrinkled look, the what is the linen material?
Yes.
That's in now. But that only works with the matching pants and jacket.
Right. You don't have some linen. It's hard to iron.
Oh yeah, it is. It, the upkeep of it is difficult.
This is a wonderful outfit. I love it. And I like the way the shirt
is hanging on the back.
Yes, that's one of my favorite styles. I like to wear.
I like that.
A longer shirt on the back. Thank you, Miss Jack.
Very nice.
And our next model is also a Jasmine.
Oh, okay. It's a Jazz too. Okay.
She is wearing a classic dressy black shirt.
Like that.
Flowers, I
should say. So now, is that a necklace or is that a brooch? What's on the front here?
It's
a necklace? Wow. Okay.
So this is going with her casual voluminous pants. And I like the way
the pants are. Yeah.
She had when she walked in, I said, "Are those capris?" And she said, "No, I rolled them up." And
so they are making them now, I believe. Jeggings. For plus size. Leggings are for your slender.
Okay.
Jeggings would be for your plus size.
Jeggings?
Yeah.
Oh,
they don't stick to you like your leggings, but they fit very neatly and you can roll the bottom up.
Okay. And
the shoes I like. They look comfortable.
Yes, those are in style too. Cut off.
Now what do you call these? The cut off boots or what do you call these? Wedges? Wow.
High top wedges.
Okay.
Those are leggings. And you know, if you have a casual pair of pants, you can always spice up your outfit by wearing a dressy block.
Oh yeah, that's saying a lot too.
It doesn't always mean that because you're wearing a casual pair of pants,
you don't have to go casual.
Right.
Yeah.
You don't have to wear a t-shirt or, you can always spice it up. And I like the way her jewelry complements her outfit. Mm-hmm. Pearls, she's got classic pearls.
And I'm noticing even with the jewelry, with this style, a lot of your younger people are wearing, they sell them now, the three bracelets together, like in a set, and you have one that's a pearl, one that's a stone, and one like she has here that's alternated. They come like that now.
Wow.
Did that come together like that? Yeah, they come with you like that.
And then her earrings, they're very you want to make sure that your
the outfit, exactly.
She's already has these nice flowers. So I think dangly earrings probably would have taken away from it.
Yeah, a little bit.
Now, with our previous model, Delmonica, her dangly earrings complement her outfit perfectly. So that's wonderful.
It's nice.
Wonderful. Can you spin around again, Jasmine, for us? And her hairstyle is also matching with her casual, kind of casual slash dress.
And I've noticed with all of them, the facial. The eyebrows, this arched, everything,
yes.
Just blended, makeup, blended skin, everything looks good.
Please get those eyebrows done. Thank you, Jasmine.
No
please,
unibrows.
Please get
no
those
unibrows.
Eyebrows done. And our final model is Jocelyn.
We got a dress.
Yes, we have a dress.
All right.
beautiful.
That's nice.
Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. And it is, I like the way it's lined in leather. That is
so this is leather around
the neck.
The neck, okay.
And the front. She told me earlier, I'm wearing a Spanx.
Okay. And you can tell because the dress is not like sticking.
Right.
Well, it's just laying on her. It's very neat.
Very neat. And her hairstyle is elegant. Very elegant hairstyle.
That's nice.
She said, I feel so bad because I'm not wearing a necklace. And I told her,
you don't need a necklace.
You don't need a necklace. This dress stands alone.
And I think that's our problem. It's, I don't know if anyone, any other ethnic race there is. We have a tendency to feel like less is not enough.
Right, right. But less is always
It's tasteful,
more.
Yeah.
And if you watch, if you take time to watch the Oscars or on the red carpet.
They don't over,
women,
yeah.
They don't wear a lot of
accessories and all
that. Over accessorized because the dress,
Speaks itself.
Exactly. The dress is the highlight. The highlight. Thank you, y'all. Looks very nice.
All of them were very lovely.
Yes.
Very lovely.
And she's wearing the black heels to go along with it. So that was our plus size fashion show tonight, and I really enjoyed it. Can you all give yourselves a hand? Models.
Yay.
So we've got to have them back for maybe a formal.
Yeah.
Formal.
And my suggestion to throw a couple of men in there to mix up the selection a little bit.
We'll do that. Well, I can't ask Mr. Birdchest. Let me stop talking about him. But anyway,
oh my Lord,
we are out of time and we're going to close out now. We want to thank I want to thank my co-host, first of all, Shantice, for sitting in with me, hanging out with me. You're going to be seeing her more. We're going to get her to host the show.
Oh, you're so sweet. Bless your heart. Just full of surprises this evening.
Our sponsors, Apostle Emma Dickens at Kingdom Empowerment Ministries, thank you so much. Aunt Brenda, Uncle Norm, I know you're watching in. I love you so much. Thank you for watching. Mom and Daddy, I know you're watching in. James Bullock Jr., he let me know today, I will be watching. And that's how he said it, I will be watching. So thank you, Mr. James Bullock Jr., for watching. And last but not least, Dr. Samuel Akpuno. I'm just going to blow you a kiss, sweetie. We're going to have all of our models come back now, and they're going to kind of stand around us and surround us so you can get one last look at them. But I want to remind you all, come on, y'all, don't be ashamed. We want to remind you all as we close out that beauty is in the eye of the beholder. So we want you to learn how to behold your own beauty. We will see you back on fourth Sunday for another episode of the Lady T Show. And this time it's going to be soul food cooking from Mama's Kitchen. Bye, everybody. We'll see you
later.
On fourth Sunday.
Bye.